Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode is powered by Hayabusa. It is all about how to fight in these MMA gloves for offense and defense. Today's video, we're breaking down how to fight in MMA gloves. With a lot of people now transitioning to mixed martial arts or mixed martial arts gaining popularity, learning how to fight in small gloves is very important. And why I'm creating this video is because all the time when we do our sparring and we see it in gyms and all of our drills, we tend to always put on big boxing gloves. But when it comes to fight time, there are very subtle differences that you need to know when throwing in a 4-ounce glove. So let's start breaking down defensively, because here, the Bazooka curriculum, we always like to focus on defense as a priority, okay? So let's talk about defense as a whole. The first thing of all types of combat sports is you have to learn to move your feet. So defense one, foot movement, small glove, that's a thumbs up for me, right? That's the most safest. If someone's trying to strike with you, move your feet. Keep your distance, keep your range. That's gonna be the safest way of moving in an MMA glove, right? But the problem is we wanna close distance, we wanna win, we want action, so we need to close that down. If you're constantly moving, I might have to jump in a little bit further, which I can get caught. So from the good outside movement, you have long, double distance, right? Extra long. If I'm fighting someone who's trying to shoot in, I'm gonna stay double the distance, nice and long, use good feints, right? Fainting becomes very important. Now, if I want to start pressuring and closing my distance, I have to start using a parry, which personally in MMA gloves is my favorite. This way I can pressure, still control hands, catch, and be able to counter back. I'm in range to be able to counter. Now, the main thing to understand with a parry and why it's effective for MMA is because you don't have to keep your hands shelled to your head, which is the third form of defense, is using the high guard shell, right? So the parry allows you a little bit more distance from the punch hitting your face compared to the wedge. And also with the wedge, sometimes, and the high guard, you can blind yourself and it's really hard to see. You have to think, this little opening might stop, you know, a boxing glove, but it's still enough for an MMA glove to go through. So I like the parry, right? So catch, catch, outside, outside. Even with powerful hooks in a small glove, I'd rather catch it disconnected from my head, because even here, taking the big shots hurts, right? Even if you're fighting someone big and strong with a boxing glove, catching out here saves that contact from the head, okay? So again, I love movement. I love the parry. High guard, if you're newer to fighting and newer to MMA, I wouldn't really say the high guard is your best option. Someone like me, who relied his whole career using a good high guard defense, I can effectively use it with a small glove. When you think about the high guard, I always talk about a wedge. Here's a little side tip for you guys, all right? A lot of gyms and people, they teach the high guard with the elbows down, right? But if you're gonna fight in MMA with the high guard, my tip for you goes, use the wedge, get the elbow up. Now, I can block a punch further away. It's like the same distance as a parry, nice and long. If I'm just sitting in mid-range with my elbow down, yes, it's gonna be very difficult for me to be able to block nice and effective, okay? But you also need to understand, as everyone who's watching this video has different levels of ground experience, right? If me, being a kickboxer, if I block a lot of punches with the high guard, it's easy for someone to shoot underneath, grab the single leg. I don't want that, right? So for me, by using the parry and punching, okay, I have more distance for the wrestler trying to shoot on me, okay? So I do have to change the types of defense, okay? That's the key. You don't always want to stay parry, you don't always want a high guard, and you don't always want to move your feet. It all depends on what you're trying to accomplish. Now, the last form of defense is head movement. Head movement, very important with small gloves. Now, there's head movement and then there's Floyd Mayweather, right? I want you to have a balance between the two. I don't want to see you bouncing and moving here in MMA. Head movement is slightly different in boxing than it is for MMA and kickboxing, right? So my preference is use the parry, the wedge, maybe slip a hook and then be able to counter off. Maybe from the outside I might move, sharpen the eyes, but I don't want to rely too much on it. We got knees coming in odd angles, head kicks, front kicks, all right, knees to the face. We just need to make sure we are always safe. That's what defense is. So if there's kicks and knees involved, I'm going to use my head movement more as a last way to maybe slip the last punch and counter, slip pull once in a while, then go back to my high guard defense. Okay, so mix and match depending on your opponents. Play around with the difference. Now, one of my other forms of defense is using a parry and a wedge at the same time. I might pressure using a wedge and a parry, okay? Mixing and matching. I might parry, wedge, head movement, okay? Mixing and matching. Then I move my feet to manage distance. All good forms of defense, safe from the 4-ounce glove. Now, let's go to some offense, okay? Offense, we wanna have offense. So what's gonna change in a small glove? First thing is, you've got to be a little bit more precise. Precision striking is very important in a small glove. Too many times we see guys breaking hands in these small gloves. One of my biggest pet peeves is you do such a good job at finding a good shot. You rock your opponent. They cover their head up, right? They put their elbows. And what do you see most fighters do? They sit there and they start bombing punches off of the elbows. And that's how you hurt your hands, okay? If someone is shelled up, you know, probe your shot, rip the body, find, boom, find the liver shot. Maybe create an angle, bang, uppercut, split the guard, you know, bang, hit the body shot, come up with a knee. Now, the one thing I always say, and I always forget a lot of times because I'm so used to boxing gloves myself, is that you got fingers, right? So even some forms of offense and defense, if someone shelled up on me, boom, I can grab the wrist, create an angle, boom. If they go to punch me, I might grab them and long guard them, keep them safe from punching me. So I can use my hands offensively and defensively, okay? So that's one of the biggest differences. So main thing for you to remember offensively, find the angle, okay? Be precise and try to place the knuckles. That's the main thing I want to leave you here with, okay? So if someone is blocking, take the body, okay? Take the angle to try to land effectively. Keep your hand safe in the small glove, all right? Now, the other thing with this important with small glove is you don't have to try as hard. The biggest mistake a lot of people make offensively is, man, I'm gonna kill someone with these small gloves. Look at them. And then they start bombing big, heavy, overthrown punches, okay? It doesn't take much. If I'm drawing someone in and I catch a nice small right hand, boom, that's enough to hurt someone, right? Especially if I'm more effective on my feet, don't want to get taken down by staying snappy, sharp, picking my shots, you know, finding my knuckles. I'm not wasting energy, I'm not overthrowing and be taken down, and I'm using timing and precision to land. That to me is the most effective. And you can see in MMA, the best strikers, you know, the Israel Adesanyas, the Conor McGregors, they don't sit there and they don't step and punch too hard. When we see Anderson Silva, he's moving, he's sharp, finding the timing, okay? So that's the type of striking you should be looking towards to develop, okay? And remember, I understand everyone's at different levels here. There might be more advanced wrestlers, more advanced grapplers, but just understand, defense is slightly different. And it's very important that you practice, you know, defensively and offensively in small gloves. Find someone you trust and work with it. Now, one suggestion I do have, with the small gloves, you tend to get scraped and hit and maybe cut a little bit more with the takedown. So a lot of times, if you're gonna spar with the small MMA gloves, think about using a head guard, headgear, just to prevent any cuts and scrapes on your eyes. Okay, I know this was a lot of information here and it was a little fast, but the idea is get thinking of how to use these gloves and the size of these gloves effectively, okay? Remember, defense changes. Drilling in MMA gloves, very important. Maybe you don't want to spar all the time in them, but it's very important at least you do your drills in them, bag work and pad work, just to get used to it. You'll notice sometimes with MMA gloves is your hands want to stay here. It's harder to find the knuckles. So sometimes turning your wrists in a little bit to help effectively land better with the knuckles is all very important. Too many times when I see guys punching bag work in MMA, I see a lot of scrapes on these knuckles. And to me, it just shows we're not landing with the proper part of the knuckles. So that's another part of the training you need to understand. I find that it's a little bit more difficult to land with knuckles in an MMA gloves, okay? So all different important parts to think about. But the most important thing you do is you like, share, and even leave a comment below to help us out here at bazookakickboxing.com. And make sure you support the channel sponsors by going to HayabusaFight.com to check out all the Hayabusa gear. We have Perfect Sports Nutrition. Use code Bazooka20 to get 20% off of your supplements. We have BazookaShop.com for all the Bazooka gear. And last but not least, BazookaTraining.com. For $9.99, that's right, less than $10 a month, you're getting 4 brand new videos a week, plus an archive that has over 100 training videos, okay? We have home workouts, we have bag workouts, tutorials, and sparring drills every Monday for you to learn. And now at this point, the concepts are high and you can still go back and learn. The whole point is go back. You can even learn single strikes, learn the jab, learn the cross. And then all of a sudden we're getting more advanced concepts. So head over to bazookatraining.com, join the team and join the curriculum. We'll see you next time here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Welcome to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA Online Training. I'm Bazooka Joe Valtellini, the owner here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Over the past year, I've designed and created a website to teach Bazooka curriculum at home and across the world. The purpose of this website is for you to, one, hit your fitness and health goals, all while learning world-class martial arts instruction from me. The beautiful thing about this website, it's geared for all levels. So if you're learning martial arts for the first time as a beginner, we help you progress into the bigger stages. And if you're a pro fighter, guess what? We have different fight concepts for you to improve your tool set and your skills in the ring or cage. As the fastest rising kickboxing world champion and a lifelong martial artist with over 30 years of experience, I've been able to combine my passion for martial arts and teaching to create this website. This website's gonna give you some of the tricks, secrets, and inside look at some of the training I use to win my world title. Once you subscribe to this site, you're gonna be getting weekly training videos and tutorials that you can do from anywhere. The sections are broken up into 3 parts. The first is bag workout. So if you have a bag at home or at your gym, you can use these workouts to supplement your training. The second is at-home workouts. A lot of us don't have the room for a bag or a bag in general, so these workouts are for no equipment needed and you can do them anywhere. And finally, the tutorial section. If you're having any problems with a specific technique or fight concept that's covered in any of the workouts, go to the tutorial section, learn the technique, and then go back to the workout, and this time, do it with proper technique. One of the added benefits once you subscribe is the forum section, where you can get a more personalized experience where you can ask questions and I'll be able to go in there and answer them. It's all about building a team and a community of martial artists helping each other grow. So subscribe now to get access to all the videos plus more so you can be part of the squad here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.